Dear students, myself Balram, mathematics lecturer. Today we deal with one of the most important topics in mathematics, that is trigonometry. So trigonometry is derived from the Greek words named as tri, which is the meaning of three, and gon, which is the meaning of angles, and metron, which is called the measure. That means trigonometric means to measure the angles of a triangle is called the trigonometry. All the triangles, now based on one triangle, that is called the right angle triangle. Before quoting the right angle triangle, now we consider one triangle, say A, B, C. Now we have to measure the sides of the triangle. The side opposite angle A, let it be measure A, small a. The remaining sides, angle B opposite side, let it be B, and angle C opposite side is let it be C. So in this triangle we have to measure the three angles named capital A, B, C, and their opposite sides like small a, small b, and small c. So in triangle we have the mainly six measures. So what are the measures? Six. First is the angles. So what are the angles here? Angle A, angle B, angle C we have to measure, and sides. So what are the sides here? A, B, and C. So these six things are mainly we have to measure in a triangle. Using this measures all the components, we can go to the any values of the triangle. So all the triangles is based on only one triangle, is nothing but right angle triangle. So right angle triangle is a triangle which is one angle is 90 degrees. So the right angle is at vertex here, let it be 90 degrees. So the angle here 90 degrees, the remaining angles we have to measure here 2 measures. Okay. The side opposite to right angle triangle is called the hypotenuse. Okay. Now we have considered the one reference angle, let it be theta. Okay. Now theta, the side adjacent to the theta is called the adjacent side. The side opposite to theta is called the opposite side. So in right angle triangle we have the hypotenuse, adjacent side, and opposite side. So in real life, how to use the right angle triangle in your life? For example, suppose David, the name we have called here, a David, measure the height of a tree. He want to measure the height of the tree. Then we can use the right angle triangle. So it is the height of the triangle, height of the tree, which we want to the measure. So some distance we have to take the person here, the David. So we have to measure the easily the distance between the person and the tree. Let it be this is the side, and angle, approximately angle we have to consider here, top of the tree, let it be theta. Using these components we have to find the height of the tree using the right angle triangle. So one more example we have to consider. Suppose there is one mountain is there. So we have to find height of the mountain. So now take the person here. Now find the distance between the mountain and the person. Let it be some x value. Now here to take some approximate angle top of the height, that is let it be theta. In that case also, using these two components, we have to find the height of the mountain. So that is the main purpose of the right angle triangle in our daily life. So before that, so okay, so main the right angle triangle is the main the focus of the all the remaining triangles. Now consider again the right angle triangle. Let it be 90 degrees. Now let it be A. Now it is the B. It is the C value. Now right angle triangle, angle the side opposite the 90 degree angle is called the hypotenuse. We have considered the one reference angle. Let it be theta. Now the side BC adjacent to the theta is there, so it is called the adjacent side. Now it is the side AC opposite the reference angle theta, so it is called the opposite side. So in right angle triangle we have the hypotenuse, adjacent side and opposite side. So one more, suppose the angle, reference angle, instead of here, suppose angle A is there, then what happened? Now observe that. So one more right angle triangle we have to consider. Generally the side opposite to 90 degrees, we have take it as hypotenuse. Now here reference angle, let it be gamma. Observe that. Here we have considered the reference angle gamma. Now the side adjacent to the reference angle is called the adjacent side. The side angle opposite to the reference angle, that is called the opposite side. Is clear? So hypotenuse cannot be interchanged, but the remaining two sides depends upon the reference angle. Here reference angle theta, so here adjacent side here, the opposite side here. If take the reference angle here, now it is the adjacent side, it is the opposite side. So next concept we have to know the, okay, here reference angle theta or gamma can be measured, theta or gamma can be measured in angles or radians. Here the angle, reference angle theta can be measured in two units, angles or radians. So we have the relation between the theta, here represents the radians, degrees or radians. Once again, here reference angle theta or gamma can be measured in degrees or radians. We have one relation between the degrees and radian, that is important, that is 90 degrees can be written as pi by 2 radians. Remember it, 90 degrees can be equal to pi by 2 radians. Suppose you want to the 180 degrees, 180 degrees will be equal to pi radians. How to get 180 degrees equal to pi radians is nothing but from above equation multiplied by 2 on both sides. 2 into 90, 180 degrees, 2 into pi by 2, we have the pi radians. One more we have to consider, one more important value is 360 degrees can be rewritten as 2 pi radians. Is clear? So 360 degrees can be written as 2 pi radians. How to get this one is nothing but, now here the equation is both sides multiplied by 4, you get the desired answer, 360 degrees equal to 2 pi radians. But in most frequently we can measure the angle in degrees, rarely we can use the in radians measure. So after angle, we have the one more concept, that is the function. So another concept we have to consider, the function. So what is the function? Function is nothing but, just like one box. Right, this is the box which has the one input, one output line is there. Okay, so function is nothing but let's consider the one function box which have the input and output. So we have to take here first pipe as a input value. Now here we have the some function will be considered, then it is out, it is the output. Okay, so it is the function box have the two pipes, one is the input, another is the output. Output is nothing but we have some function will be exist in this function, then we have get the output. For example, now again I consider the one function box, one input pipe, one is output pipe. Okay, now here what is the function means, it is multiplied by 5. What I'm saying that the function inside can be taken as multiplied by 5. For example, now I can input value, I can consider the 2. So inside box it is multiplied by 5, so output will be 10 exist. Now secondly, I can input the 2 value input pipe, so some function will be exist here, the function will be 15. Similarly 4 cannot consider, the output value will have the 20. So here it is the function box, this function box so taken as f of x can be written as 5x. Okay, the function denoted by f of x equal to 5x. For example, in the place of x I can substitute the 2, some function will be exist, that means the 5 is, the x value is multiplied by 5, the output is 10. Suppose 3 will be substituted, for f of 3 we have the 15 value. Okay, like that 4 we substitute, we get the 20 value. So function is nothing but we have take some input value, some function will be carry on, the output will come, so it is nothing but function. So remember that only function concept here only. Okay, so in trigonometry we have to several functions can be used. So in that mainly 3 functions I can explain. What are the 3 functions in trigonometric? 3 function. The first one is sine function. For this I can consider the one right angle triangle. It is the hypotenuse. Now let it be reference angle theta. Now it become adjacent side. Now it is the opposite side. Okay, now it is the again define the sine function. Sine function can be written as sine theta. Sine function can be written as sine theta and defined as ratio of opposite side by hypotenuse. So sine theta can be defined as opposite side by hypotenuse. Simply we can write opposite side divided by hypotenuse. So remember here one point, sine function, in the sine I can eliminate the e value, simply I can write sin theta, so e is the eliminate. So simply we can write sine theta equal to opposite side by hypotenuse. In the same way we can second function given as cosine function. So cosine function can be denoted by cos theta can be defined as the ratio of adjacent side by hypotenuse. For cos theta can be defined as adjacent side by hypotenuse. Simply we can write adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. Here also we have to observe that in the cosine function ine we have to eliminate, so we can simply write cos, cos theta. Okay, in the same way the third function can be defined as tangent function. It is simply we can written as tan theta. So tan theta can be defined as opposite side divided by adjacent side. So tan theta can be defined as opposite side by adjacent side. So we can write opposite side divided by adjacent side. Okay, so we have to observe that the three main function in trigonometry that called the sine theta, cos theta and tan theta. Using these three functions, we can play with them. So how to play? First, suppose I consider sine theta divided by cos theta. Sine theta divided by cos theta. Sine theta by cos theta can rewrite in another way. Sin theta into 1 by cos theta. We know that sin theta can be taken as sin theta into 1 divided by cos theta. So what is the sin theta? Sin theta is defined as opposite side by hypotenuse. So we can write opposite side divided by adjacent side. Now here 1 by cos theta. That means cos theta reciprocal here. So cos theta reciprocal 1 by cos theta. So cos theta reciprocal what? Here cos theta is defined as adjacent side by hypotenuse. Its reciprocal can be written as hypotenuse. It is the hypotenuse divided by adjacent side. Okay. So observe that here some calculation. Hypotenuse will be cancelled. The final simplification now opposite side divided by adjacent side. Remember that now finally we have one result, opposite side by adjacent side. It is equivalent to is nothing but third function, opposite side by adjacent, which is equal to tan theta. So we get one most important relation between in trigonometric ratios, that is a sin theta by cos theta will be equal to tan theta. Is clear? So it is the most important relation between the sin theta, cos theta and tan theta, that is sin theta by cos theta equal to tan theta. So in this I have to find the remaining relations. Okay, now how to remember all the trigonometric functions in short way. Okay, once again recall the sin theta value. According to sin theta value, you have the opposite side divided by adjacent side, and cos theta can be written as hypotenuse adjacent side divided by hypotenuse, and tan theta can be written as opposite side by adjacent side. So remember the points. The first formula sin theta. What are the first letter here? Sin theta is equal to opposite by hypotenuse. Now observe the first letter. S O H. So we have write the S O H. And second formula cos theta written as adjacent side by hypotenuse. C A H. C A H. And the third formula tan theta written as opposite by adjacent. T O A. Which is we can read the easy way, so katva. If you remember the so katva, have to find the all trigonometric ratios. So katva. The first letter represents here S O H. For example, we consider one right angle triangle. Okay, having a trace 3, 4, 5, that is reference angle theta. Now we have to find the sin theta. Okay, you want to find the sin theta. Remember the formula, so katva. Sin theta means S O H. So sin theta written as opposite by adjacent. So sin theta is equal to opposite by hypotenuse. So that is the 3 divided by 5. The second function, cos theta, that is the cos. So cos is equal to adjacent by hypotenuse. Now adjacent by hypotenuse 4 by 5. And tan theta similarly we can define as 12. So opposite by adjacent, that is the 4. So if you remember this, so half, you have to find the all 6 trigonometric ratios. First, we have to mainly we have to use the sine, cos, tan three functions. If you know these three, we have to find the remaining three functions so as easily.